Arise. God said, "It is not good for man to be alone. I will make a helper suitable for him." Then the Lord God made a woman from the rib he had taken out of the man, and he brought her to the man. The man said, "This is now bone of my bones and flesh of my flesh. For this reason, a man will leave his father and mother and be united to his wife, and they will become one flesh." A woman of noble character, who can find? She is worth far more than rubies. Her husband has full confidence in her and lacks nothing of value. She brings him good, not harm, all the days of her life. A marriage has always been a joyous occasion. In Cana of Galilee, it was gladdened by the presence and blessing of the Lord Jesus himself. Because God intended marriage to bring blessing and joy to your lives, let us invoke his presence as you make your covenant before him and these guests. Let us pray. Heavenly Father, we thank you for the joy of this occasion in uniting Sharon and Joseph in holy matrimony according to your design and according to the institution which you have created for our well-being. And we ask, Lord, that as we celebrate this wedding and as this couple makes their vows, Lord, that you would be a witness to these vows and that all of us would be a witness to these vows to support and to encourage this couple as they embark on marriage and their life together as husband and wife. In Jesus' name, amen. Who gives Sharon to be wed to Joseph? Now, Joseph's scriptures say to the husband, "Husbands, love your wives just as Christ loved the church and gave himself up for her to make her holy, cleansing her by the washing with water through the word, and to present her to himself as a radiant church without stain or wrinkle or any other blemish, but holy and blameless. In this same way, husbands ought to love their wives as their own bodies." And Sharon, the scriptures say to the wife, "Wives, submit to your husbands as to the Lord, for the husband is the head of the wife, as Christ is the head of the church, his body, of which he is the Savior. Now as the church submits to Christ, so also wives should submit to their husbands in everything. And to you both, the scriptures say, submit to one another out of reverence for Christ." Marriage was instituted by God himself, and he performed the first marriage. When a man and a woman have chosen each other and have come to that moment when they sincerely and publicly join in this covenant for life, they lay down on the altar a holy sacrifice to God, to each other, and to humanity. The union into which you are now about to enter is the closest and most tender into which human beings can come. It is a union founded on mutual experience and affection, and to believers in the Lord Jesus Christ, it is a union in the Lord. Marriage is God's institution, intended for the happiness and welfare of humankind. The scriptures further say, love is patient, love is kind, it does not envy, does not boast, it is not proud, it is not rude, it is not self-seeking, it is not easily angered, it keeps no record of wrongs. Love does not delight in evil, but rejoices with the truth. It always protects, always trusts, always hopes, always perseveres. A union embodying such ideals is not to be entered into lightly or unadvisedly, but reverently, discreetly, soberly, and in the fear of God. Into such a union, you come now to be joined. Now we're going to have the questions of intent. Before God and these witnesses, will you, Joseph, take Sharon to be your wife? Will you love and comfort her, honor and keep her, and in joy and sorrow, preserve with her this bond, holy and unbroken, until the coming of our Lord Jesus Christ, or as long as you both shall live? And Sharon, before God and these witnesses, will you, Sharon, take Joseph to be your husband? Will you love and comfort him, honor and keep him, and in joy and sorrow preserve with him this bond, holy and unbroken, until the coming of our Lord Jesus Christ, or as long as you both shall live?
I do.
Now let's, before God, enter into the vows. And I would like to explain something that most people probably have not heard before. But as we look at this celebration, we see that there's an aisle in the middle, and there's half the guests are seated on this side, the other half of the guests are seated on the other side. That parallels to an experience that Abraham had with God, in which God was making a covenant with Abraham. Marriage is a covenant. It's not a contract. It's not an agreement. And it is a covenant that is made before God with witnesses. Now, when Abraham and God made a covenant, God instructed Abraham to divide the sacrifice and then to walk between the two sides of the sacrifice, which was a ritual intended to communicate that if Abraham failed to live up to the covenant, may it happen to him what happened to the sacrifice. So as we see the holiness of marriage and the fact that the couples walk between two halves of the witnesses, it reminds us of that covenant that God had with Abraham. And as witnesses to this covenant, each and every one of us have the right and the duty to pray for them and to support them in their marriage. And marriage, Jesus said, is to be a lifelong commitment between a man and a woman, and specifically, until death do us part, which is according to the teaching of Jesus. Now, the interesting thing is that when you come across Scripture and you see the teaching of Jesus about the reason why marriage needs to be until death do us part, the reason is because the very next paragraph talks about the well-being of children. And Jesus says that children, anyone that causes a little one that believes in him to stumble, it would be better for him not to have been born. And so the reason that Christ taught that marriage should be until death do us part is for the sake of the children. But also, the relationship between the man and the woman need to reflect the relationship between Christ and the church. Marriage is actually a picture or a metaphor of the relationship between the church of Jesus Christ and the Lord Jesus Christ himself. And as we participate in this celebration, we want to remember that the most important thing for any marriage is for both to be absolutely certain that they have eternal life and that they believe in Jesus Christ as their Lord and Savior. I was able to sit down and talk to Joseph and Sharon, and we talked about this. And then we talked about many areas that are important and vital for a marriage to work. We went through a number of areas, and I'm happy to say that they are in good shape. And I think that we are, it's a happy occasion, but also it's a great source of joy to know that we can have confidence in this couple, that in many areas, communication and many other practical areas, they really scored fairly high. And so I think we can have confidence that this is going to be a very blessed marriage. So now, having said that, we will now have the couple repeat the vows. I, Joseph, take you, Sharon.
I, Joseph, take you, Sharon.
To be my wife.
To be my wife.
To have and to hold.
To have and to hold.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
For better, for worse.
For better, for worse.
For richer, for poorer.
Richer, for poorer.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
To love and to cherish.
To love and to cherish.
As long as we both shall live.
As long as we both shall live.
To this I pledge myself truly.
To this I pledge myself truly.
With all my heart.
With all my heart.
And Sharon, repeat after me. I, Sharon, take you, Joseph.
I, Sharon, take you, Joseph.
To be my husband.
To be my husband.
To have and to hold from this day forward.
To have and to hold from this day forward.
For better, for worse.
For better, for worse.
For richer, for poorer.
For richer, for poorer.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
To love and to cherish.
To love and to cherish.
As long as we both shall live.
As long as we both shall live.
To this I pledge myself truly.
To this I pledge myself truly.
With all my heart.
With all my heart.
As a token of this covenant, you will now receive the marriage rings. Okay. And now you may face each other. The unbroken circle, the emblem of eternity, and the gold, the emblem of that which is least tarnished and most enduring, are to show how lasting is the pledge you have made to each other. With these emblems of purity and endless devotion, you wed, and these marriage vows you hear, and these marriage vows you hear and now forever seal. Let us pray. Heavenly Father, creator of life, author of salvation, and giver of all good gifts, look with favor upon Joseph and Sharon, who have covenanted marriage in your name. Bless their union and sustain them in your devotion to each other and to you. Grant them the desire to order their lives according to your will, that in their relationship with each other and those around them, they may show forth the joy and love of Christ. Sustain them in the seasons and conditions of their lives by the power of your Holy Spirit, that in joy and sorrow, leisure and labor, plenty and want, they may give thanks for your steadfast love and declare your faithfulness before this broken and fallen world. Give them a deep burden for the salvation of souls from every tongue, tribe, and nation. Keep ever vivid in their hearts the consummation of your kingdom, and enable them to live out their lives as a quest to fulfill their particular calling in it, and so hasten your return. By the power of the Spirit and in Jesus' name, we pray. Amen. Insomuch as you, Joseph, and you, Sharon, have thus consented in holy matrimony and have witnessed the same before God and these friends, by virtue of the authority vested in me as a minister of the Word of God, and by the laws of the state, I now pronounce you husband and wife. Therefore, what God has joined together, let man not separate. You may kiss your bride. Henceforth, you travel life's road together. Let love guide all your relationships. May Christ be the head of your home, the unseen guest at every meal, and the silent listener to every conversation. May heaven's constant benediction crown your union with increasing joy and blessedness, and unite your hearts and lives by the grace and true affection of a happy marriage. The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face to shine upon you and be gracious to you. The Lord turn his face towards you and give you peace. In the name of the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Amen.
I present to you Mr. and Mrs. Joseph Higgins.